We're on a really interesting mission today. You know, over the course of a season, you know, we do a lot of different television shows, and most of the time we're releasing fish. Today, we're on a little bit of a different strategy. We're talking harvest. We're on the famed shores of Leech Lake. It's fall, fish are moving shallow, and we're gonna go see if we can catch some eaters.
A little wind, little walleye chop, and I'm always up for thumping a few of those Waldos.
It should be an interesting mission, but we're gonna talk a lot about a wide variety of different topics, everything from angling technology, selective harvest, as well as management philosophy, which is changing with the technologies we have today.
Closed captioning is provided by Smooth Moves, adjustable boat seat suspensions for a smoother ride.
You know, we're on Leech Lake, it's fall, and a lot of times what you'll have is pretty dramatic movements of bait fish, specifically shiners and perch will move up on shallow flats, and the walleyes follow them up there. The intriguing thing is the fish are spread out and they're in small pods of fish. It wasn't that long ago when, before we even had side imaging, they were sort of hard to find these fish. You'd randomly get up and you'd bounce through them, and it was really even hard to see them on 2D sonar because the fish would spook away from the boat. But today with technology, we can drive over these flats. I'm looking in around the boat 65 foot that way, 65 foot that way, and I can just literally drop coordinates on these isolated schools of fish, and then what we're going to do is put the trolling motor down and fish right through and cast directly to those schools. There's a whole bunch of them right here, Jeff. Yep. Straight in front of the boat, 30 feet. Got him. Ooh, he looks like the right model. I like these guys. These guys are my favorite. An eater. We got one. This guy is going into the box. You know, over the last number of years, our angling technology has changed so dramatically. You know, it wasn't that long ago, all we had was 2D sonar. And then we went to side imaging, which gave us, enabling us to have a wider perspective as we're moving and trying to find fish. But there they are, there's a whole bunch of them right there. And then we've actually come up with down imaging, and this new latest, this forward-looking sonar is just, it's amazing in the fact that I don't cast as much. What I'll do is I'll drive around and I'm actually looking for fish to actually cast directly to those fish. Like right there, there's a whole bunch of them. There's probably six or eight walleyes in that direction, right in front of the boat. And we're just casting directly to those individual fish. Right about there. I'm right on the money. We'll see if we can get them to bite here. But it's really intriguing on how fast the angling technology has changed. It really is. There's another one. A little bit better one. Yeah, yeah. Ooh, this one here may even be a nettable model, but I don't think it's a keeper. Wow, he's a toughie, I do know that much. It's a really nice one. It's a Leech Lake special there. You what? Come here, oh, there you go. I like that. You can even take him out of the net for me. And let that one go. He's too big. We're not gonna keep him. You know, one thing, in today's day and age, you gotta be really aware of the regulations on the given lakes. You know, in Minnesota, we're pretty progressive in the fact that individual bodies of water have different slot limits. On Leech here, we have 1/20 with a total of 4 in the boat, but only one can be over 20. We'll get another minnow out.
You know, James is absolutely right. And there's a reason that they put these different regulations on different bodies of water. Based on, you know, it's a lot of variables, obviously, but fishing pressure is probably the main one. And as we've gone along here, you know, electronics have gotten so good that you can jump in as kind of a new angler, and the learning curve, I'm not saying it's disappeared, but it has been shrunk dramatically. You know, you can come out here with these good electronics, with the map, you can drive right to the spots. They used to take people, you know, years to find. It's all good. You know, we've always been worried about fishing pressure and what that has on the fishing population. That's why the regulations are in place, you know, to preserve the fisheries for years to come.
There we go. Flipped it right into the fray, and you get a nibble. This is really what walleye fishing's about, too, you know what I mean? It's not only the catching part of it, but the eating part of it, too. And you're talking, that is about as good as it gets when it comes to walleyes. When you're talking eaters, that's a beautiful fish. Leech Lake is, you know, known. It's got, you know, quite a few big fish in it, but it's got a tremendous numbers of these size fish that actually people keep to eat. And that's what we're doing here.
This segment is brought to you by Big Bite Baits, designed to bring the big bite to your line.
Well, there's another school right there, James, huh?
Mark.
Mark.
Save another waypoint. There's another school of walleyes.
Yeah, that's right. You know, James's boat is set up. This thing is like a stealth fighter. He's got two Humminbirds in the front. He's got two here on the console. And what he's doing right now is he's using one of his technology advances, and that is side imaging. So he's cruising along, he's spotting schools of fish, and he's marking waypoints. You know, and then after that, we're gonna apply another technological advance. So, boy, anglers today are super efficient. We have the technology at our fingertips that it just makes fishing and finding fish so much easier and so much more efficient.
You can see what this is. These are just giant schools of walleyes. There's probably 30 fish right there. There's another five or six there. There's five or six there. But that's, you know, what side imaging can do. You get up on these big sand flats and it's amazing. I think, Mr. Simpson, I think we're gonna get a bite in here. We're gonna see. Okay.
Got one.
Got him. That's what I mean. You cast right into him. A little bit better one, huh? A little bit better pack of them in here. I thought you were supposed to be keeping eaters.
Ooh, that's still a nice eater.
That's a nice eater? Okay. That is a nice eater. Wow.
Talk about a subtle bite, huh, James?
Yeah.
Super subtle, but I'll tell you what, just with the electronics that we're using, James has got the MegaLive up there, and we're watching those packs of fish, and we can see exactly where they are. We're really slowing way down on the presentation, and we're starting to pick up a few of these good-eating Waldos.
What we've been doing a lot here is more or less like headhunting the fish, and what I mean by that, I got this forward-looking MegaLive on, or forward mode, and when we're moving along, and as we're moving along, I'm intermittently taking the trolling motor and sweeping back and forth like this and isolating where there's small pods of fish. Once we see that group of fish, I just put the trolling motor on spot lock and we keep on pitching into that fish right here. There's not a lot of cover on this flat and there's a lot of bait and the fish are moving around, so these schools are moving around, just wandering around on this flat. But you can see the efficiency of this forward-looking sonar is just amazing, because we can actually, in many cases, we can actually flip our jig out. You can watch the jig drop right into the schools and fish, and you can see the fish moving around. There he is.
Attaboy, James.
Now, that's what I mean. It's amazing. You cast it out to him, and you got him. There's a nice run of fish in here. It really is.
Need a net or you got him?
This guy here is right on the bubble. He is sort of a nettable model. I don't know if he's a keeper or not. He might be too big. Yep. Oh, boy, he's right on the bubble.
I think he might be.
I don't know if he's, there we go. What?
Oh, he's
nice. You want to check him?
I'm originally from South Dakota. I know my eaters.
Do you? Can you say he's in the fold?
He's right on the perfect bubble line there.
I would have to check, make sure you
want measure him.
You wanted to measure him, yeah.
He's 19.
He is perfect.
Yeah.
This boat is rigged up about as nice, easy to use, and it flat out works.
It's a must-have when you're talking about big waves. Well, these trout are so darn tough.
This bait is legendary.
So that was on a number 8 shad wrap.
Your style of boat control is really key.
One that was there from the very beginning.
Do you want to be able to see in the water?
The adventure begins.
Now you're talking. Get the net. I got one too. Yep.
Push this one in here.
Now you're talking.
Now we're talking.
Now we got the combine out. Here we go.
I was gonna wait to bring yours back to the boat, but we'll have to recoup.
Perfect eaters.
It is.
Got him. Mr. Simpson, I need the net again. Or is he just a real toughie?
Holy moly. Like,
boy, did you see that? He came up and just launched it.
So cool.
There you go.
That's nice fish.
Wow. Beautiful Waldos. The problem is, he's not of the right ilk. Oh boy, look at that. He had that hardball down the hatch. There we go. Classic presentation for catching Leech Lake walleyes. Rainbow minnow and little chartreuse hardball jig, EMC. It puts him in the boat. We'll get this guy back in the water. You know, today we've actually been catching almost all the walleyes in a classic fall presentation, which is just a VMC hardball quarter ounce jig with a rainbow minnow on there. I have this rigged on an Icon 6.8 medium power extra fast action snap jigging rod. This is about as good as it gets for this technique, no question about it. I got 10 pound 832 braid, fluorocarbon, Suffolk fluorocarbon leader, a couple of feet long. And then I got it spooled on a Kage reel, a 250 Kage Daiwa spinning reel, real smooth drag, this is a real bread and butter technique, rod and reel for walleye fishing like this. The intriguing thing is I was out here about 2 days ago. The fish were in a lot more of a positive mood and we were to fish a lot more faster reactionary baits. And what I mean by that, we were using this. Just a jigging wrap. And a lot of people would say, well, you're using a jigging wrap and you'll see that we're in fishing anywhere between 7 and 9 foot of water. That's really pretty shallow. Up on Leech Lake, I know a lot of the guides fish up here on the sand with this bait a lot. And you know, in a lot of places it's relatively clean. You don't have that much weeds. You can fish this and it's a real faster presentation, especially the way we were fishing with the MegaLive when we were casting right into them. It was a really efficient means to catch them. The other bait that was really, really hot the other day was this moontail. This is a quarter ounce VMC moontail jig. The interesting thing about this moontail, what I did is I actually was getting a number of short strikes where it seemed like they were grabbing this long bucktail and missing the bait. And so what I did is I put this quick strike stinger system on there. And you wouldn't believe almost all the fish I caught, and I caught a bunch of them, but I caught them on the stinger hook, not on the main hook. You know, it just depends, you know, how the bait is, you know, ripping off the bottom and falling really quickly to the bottom, and the walleyes would just snap at it. And a lot of the fish were caught on that stinger hook. Last but not least, if one mainstream technique to catch walleyes at this time of the year is a swim bait, and this is a big bite suicide shad 3.5 inch bait on a quarter ounce jig head. And again, we're fishing this normally with a pretty fast reactionary retrieve with this thing. It seems like to me a lot of times when you're fishing a swim bait like that, you give it that rip and it slowly falls back to the bottom, rip it up, let it falls back to the bottom, really triggers fishing to biting it. But the thing is what I'm saying is it really depends on the mood of the fish, and the fish obviously are in a little bit of a different mood today, where that live bait or the minnow and the jig combo seemed like it worked the best. But the thing is, you know, if it warms up, maybe the water's gonna warm up, that fish's attitude could change and these other more reactionary baits may trigger more fish into biting.
Got one.
Got him.
Hope you're right on him again, buddy.
But, yeah. Mega put you on.
Yeah,
I know. That's what I mean. It's just such an amazing technology, and you can see how you could apply it to other fishing situations.
Want
to
couple of those ones. Look,
you've got the big kahuna.
I don't think those ones that don't taste too good.
Ooh, we got the net out. Now you're talking.
You gotta enjoy catching a few of these whoppers too, when you're on the hunt, don't you?
Oh, there you go, big boy. Look at what he got here. That's a Leech Lake special, right? They're beautiful fish. Look at that sucker. I'll be such a nice guy for you. You got the moon eye sort of perched in his snout. Look at that guy. Beautiful fish. Jeff, he could be that's a good one there.
Yeah.
Look at that guy there, beautiful fish.
Nice, huh?
Gorgeous.
On a day of walleye fishing too, you get out here, we're obviously on a bit of a run, right? Trying to catch supper for the youngsters, but yeah. Boy, you get a couple of these mixed in, that makes the day.
The intriguing thing about this technology is also you can actually, in many cases, you can see how the fish is reacting to your bait, whether it be positive or negative.
What do you got, buddy?
Another eater. Nice one. Look at them, how beautiful they are in the water. Really. Come here, buddy. That's a whippersnapper if you've ever seen one. Come here, buddy. Whoa. Look at that. One more for the box. How many do we get?
We got one more after this.
This is it? We're getting close.
We are loaded for bear. We got
There's so many different ways to fish for walleye. Dependability and efficiency.
Simple, fast, and easy.
The best rods on the planet. They like to eat when you're throwing the right thing.
You don't have all bluebird flat calm days.
Just a perfect eating size fish.
See, that's what I'm talking about, this guy with drag.
There he is. Oop. Up.
Ugh.
You know what?
Uh-huh.
Mr. Simpson, I think we just hit the quota. Is that all right?
Yeah.
It is. Perfect.
You know, James and I set out on a mission today, and that was to catch, walleyes in that 15 to 17 inch class, harvest those fish, and that's part of walleye fishing. I can guarantee a lot of hardcore walleye anglers, the whole game is to come out, start fishing, find the fish, catch the fish, and harvest the fish. And there's nothing wrong with that. That is walleye 101. That's the game. And that said, walleye anglers have grown and grown and grown, and there are so many good walleye anglers out here on the water today. Combine that with the electronics we have, the mapping we have, boy, it's pretty easy to get on a batch of fish and to beat up on them pretty quickly. And that's where the state regulations come in. We need to have these regulations in place to sustain the fisheries. We know, with past has told us that over-harvesting a fishery can really damage it. I'm talking for a decade or two. So these regulations are in place for a reason. That's so we can have sustainable walleye fisheries for years to come.
Overtime. Well, this is really nice. I got this case that came with it. Before I leave, I throw some Ziplocs. I just throw Ziplocs in there, so we can put our fillets in there afterwards. So I'll just set those off the side. But we better get cranking here.
We realize Mr. Simpson is from South Dakota, and he's really used to
well-trained.
Processing fish is key.
I did. I grew up fishing, doing this a lot. And there was a time when I wanted to be really fast, but I actually, slow down. I take pride in getting, just really getting the perfect fillets off of these things. But these knives are super, super nice. Once you get on to cleaning with an electric knife, you can become really efficient with it. These fillets are coming out really white and nice. Before we brought them in here, James went in here with the Bubba scissors and cut them right here. And that bleeds them out. And that really improves the fillet. Got all the hides off. Now I'm just going to go back and remove all the rib cages. Show another little trick. Once you get the, you just kind of flip it up. Once you get it going about like that, you can flip the fillet over and put your knife right here and peel it off. Okay, so the final step, I'm gonna take the skin down here partway and then back the knife off and cut the skin. And what that does, that leaves the skin on there. So if we get checked on the way home, this is required by some states. And when Jim gets home, he's got room to work. He can go in there and just take that off of the knife. If I just cut straight down there, he'd have a hard time getting the knife back in there. It's really hard to get that skin off. So that's what you want for transportation right there. Boom.
We're talking a fun day of fishing, no question about that.
You know, every year I get a whole bunch of emails like I'm holding here. These particular ones I've kept throughout the season because there was something that was said in them that I thought at some point might be interesting for a closing. Most of them are really uplifting, love the show, love the ending of the show, rah, 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 keep doing what you're doing. But every once in a while, I get one or I see somebody in a restaurant or they come up to me, and it isn't rare, at a boat landing or something, and they say, hey, I love your show, it's really great, but I don't like the closes. I don't like you shoving your beliefs down my throat. I'm not shoving my beliefs down anybody's throat. I'm sharing my beliefs. I'm not shoving them. I'm sharing with you my beliefs, my experiences in the world that we live in today, things from the Word of God, in hope that it inspires you, gives you something to look forward to the day. These are things that have touched me in special ways, and that's why I'm sharing it with you. I definitely do not intend to shove anything down your throat. God gave you a free will. What an amazing gift. You got a free will. You can sit there, receive it, listen to it, maybe be blessed by it. That's a desire of my heart. Or you could turn it off. Free will is such a blessing when you use it right. Hey, from all of us here at The Edge, you have a good, safe fishing season.